Hi friends, I am Nikhil and welcome back to my channel Wiser Rider Macha. Friends, just now I am heading to meet one of the top bike customizer in India. He is a professional Royal Enfield customizer. So friends, without wasting any time, let's meet him at his own workplace. So friends, as I said earlier, I just now reached to Puranam Designs. So you may get a question, what is Puranam Designs? So let's hear about Puranam Designs from the man himself. So brother, first tell me, what is Puranam Designs about?
Hi everyone. Puranam Designs is a bike customization studio where we make different designs of mostly Royal Enfields, because that's where people are more fond about. And we have been in this business for the past 8 years now. Most of our operations were in Delhi. We started from Vishakhapatnam itself, but here the pickup in the market, the clientele and all coincidentally matched more from Delhi. So that's where we started. And off late, what has happened with these kinds of bikes, where the modifications, if I can show you, it's a bit more minimal and not much. So this is the kind of work where people in Vizag and down south mostly look at. So then we thought of, why not branch out from Vishakhapatnam too, and this is our office where we started, and we have been here for the past now 3 years now.
What is the next project that you are working on?
Now that I have completed this bike, I already have two more projects running. Both the bikes are from some other states. It will take at least a month or so to complete them. But yeah, they are pretty interesting. And I think once we release the photograph after the completion, definitely it will be another two eye-catching models to look for.
That's very ear-pleasing. And also, what inspired you to make this particular Garuda?
Well, this one is on the model. This is a classic 350, and it's a 2015 model, if I am correct on the RC. This was on ash color, right? So the client wanted something of a retro feel, where he wanted to play around with that ash color and something unique color to look for, along with the vintage appeal of the bike. So if you can see, we have completely transformed, although it seems to be very minimalistic work, but if you look at the whole caricature of the bike, the whole design perspective, like we have same classic handle have been modified to suit the oldish handlebars what you used to get in the 1980s and 70s model. Similarly, the headlamp there is being taken from the 1960s British made Royal Enfields, where it comes, where it used to come with a independent headlight setup.
Could you please explain us, what are the modifications that you have made onto this?
So the modifications what we have done, right, to start with, this is the tire what we have used, the same stock tire of 90 by 90 by 19, which comes in a stock rim setup. But we have changed the pattern. We have taken Ralco, which gives a very block pattern, and this looks pretty rugged given the whole design of this bike. Then we have added a small number plate which used to come in the old models. That's pretty something to look for. Similarly, we have modified the T of this bike. If you can see, the normal setup which comes with a Royal Enfield is this T. So we have changed this setup to this. This is an independent setup which used to be in the models which were like pre-1970 era. Modify lot of stock things which come with this classic, particularly this 2015 model, where we have modified the whole T setup. This is a new part which we have sourced. Even the headlight clamps also we have sourced. The amp meter is being placed differently. This whole setup is completely done. Even the handle, nowadays you get only the classic 350 straight handlebars. But this we have used, if you can see the angle of this, you know, the whole angle, the way this handlebar is made, this will replicate the old style of handles what we used to had before 2000.
Okay, what about this leather wrap?
This is a finishing kind of a leather wrap what we have done to match the seats. When we decided the paint theme of this bike, which was ash, so the customer wanted something which is very unique on this bike, and color is the very much important and critical part of any project. So here, if you can see the whole contrast what we have played around, like the black and the gray and the red, we have used red very minimal, only with some, you know, red carpet kind of a theme what we have created. We have created a red seat along with the grips. We have wrapped it with the same cloth what we have used in the seats. And then once you come on the rear, again matching the tires in the front, we have the same Ralco with 130x70x18, which has the same pattern of, you know, blocks what you have. Again, this gives a very rugged kind of a look. And if here on the rear, if you look, we have changed the whole setup of danger lamp, which is pretty neat and looks pretty vintage era. To match all this theme of arrangements, we have used Thunderbird's indicator setup, both front and the rear. We have used a short bottle. So we have used the old bottle silencer which used to come in the old models. Now, because of the emission norms, the silencers has taken a hit, and we have a lot of new emission norms being played. Now latest we have is BS6. So again, to match the whole theme of bike with the black, we have wrapped it with the blackish wrapping on the silencer pipe. Again, we have done a rugged black color wrapping on the leg guard. So this overall, it gives a very pretty vintage kind of a feel. We have used the red not much, just to keep the contrast and the, you know, red carpet kind of a theme, which is pretty eye-catching. We have used the red in very less number of places, but wherever we have used, it has been a bit prominent. Definitely, it has appealed.
And could you please explain about this particular?
This one, the client wanted, actually we suggest a name. We ask for a name what a client wants for his bike. Because bike is something which everyone, whoever rides a bike or motorcycle, especially if you are talking on bullets, so everyone has a name, right? So since it's a unique project, every bike, we ask the client that what kind of name are you looking for your bike. Based on that, we develop a theme. So this one, the client wanted a name Garuda. Actually, it was the eagle, flying eagle or something was pretty much what he was looking for. But then in our previous projects, we have already done Falcon, Eagle, you know, all this stuff. So what best could be done, then we suggested, why not Garuda? Once it was Garuda, then we were looking for a particular picture, which could be unique, which could be very much intricate to look on, and at the same time, it should be appealing. So this is what we got. And this has been done with a stencil kind of a thing to on this tank, and that's where we and the, myself and the client were in agreement that yeah, this is something which we can look for, and this is the picture what should be there on the tank, which is pretty prominent and really very eye catching.